Hi, and welcome to How Do I Earn My Clear Designated Subjects Credential? You know, that's the question we hear the most from new teachers. There are quite a few factors at play when answering that question, as every teacher has a different set of circumstances. This is due to their completion of college or trade coursework, exams they may have taken, or even the amount of teaching experience they have. One thing is for sure, when you have a preliminary designated subjects credential, you will need to complete four courses: the early program orientation class, the foundations class, either the CTE or adult education emphasis class, and the portfolio class. Please note, taking these classes through SDCOE also meets the CTC computer technology and the English learner SDI requirement. Now, these courses must be taken in order and completed with a passing mark. They cannot be taken at the same time as they are sequential, but they need to be completed before your 3-year or your 5-year, for all you ROTC folks, preliminary credential expires. In addition, you may have other requirements identified by the Commission on Teacher Credentialing. You'll need 2 years of successful teaching experience under your preliminary designated subjects credential. To meet the U.S. Constitution requirement, you either can take a 2-semester unit class or pass an exam through an approved college, university, or program. You'll need to complete a health education course that includes a study of nutrition, as well as the physiological and sociological effects of alcohol, narcotics, drugs, and the use of tobacco. You'll need to be certified in CPR and must show proof of training in a CPR class that includes infants, children, and adults. There's also that computer technology requirement, but remember, this is covered through the 4 SDCOE designated subjects courses, as is the English learner SDI requirement. Side note, SDI stands for Specially Designed Academic Instruction in English. Still not sure if you have any or all of these additional requirements? Check with your school district's Human Resources Department, or go to the ctc.ca.gov and search for your credential, or contact the SDCOE Credentialing Department for assistance. What are the final steps? Well, once you have fulfilled all the requirements, you will apply for the CLEAR credential through your district's Human Resources Department. They can assist you in completing the application and will send all the materials necessary to our office for processing. You can do it!